Hi, my name's Phillip Slater, and for the next couple of minutes, I'd just like to give you something to think about. The effective and efficient management of spare parts inventory relies on the input from people from a whole range of different functions from within the organisation. So if I'm thinking about spare parts that are used to support operational activities, so to support your plant equipment, keep it going, then you need to have the input of people from maintenance, most probably engineering, perhaps even operations. You're going to need the input from people from the storeroom function and logistics. You're going to need input from purchasing and procurement, and of course there'll always be input from finance. The problem is that each of these functions can look at the issue of spare parts management and have a completely different perspective. Of course, maintenance want as many spares available as quickly as possible because they've got to get the plant running again, they've got to get their PMs done and so forth. Purchasing and procurement, well, they're working hard to make sure they get the best deal in buying spares for the company. Of course, storeroom are the people who are just in the middle of this, getting yelled at by everybody, and finance will be setting limits on how much can be spent. But what if, just think, what if each of these functions could understand the perspective of the others? You see, typically, each of these functions sees their part of the picture. But what if they could see the whole picture? What if they could understand the perspective of the others and the constraints within which they need to work? What if we could understand what's required as a group to bring about effective and efficient spare parts inventory management? Well, it is possible, but you need to work at it. So something to think about today is how can you get your teams to work together with a common goal, understanding all of the constraints in order to improve your spare parts inventory management. That's something to think about. My name's Phillip Slater.